Jessica from Blog About It All, and I am sharing on the blog about how to create an emergency preparedness kit. Well, I have our kit right here, and I'm just going to show you some of the things that we put inside our tub. That way we are ready in case of an emergency or would need to, you know, get through a power outage or possible evacuation. Experiencing the recent shelter in place order and going through the shortage of toilet paper and, you know, all the food supply stuff that was running low at the stores has me looking at being prepared for an emergency with a whole new perspective in mind. I've been pretty good and diligent about having an emergency fund for unexpected finance things that pop up, but I haven't been as diligent with having an emergency preparedness kit. On the blog post, you'll find all the details of the products that we placed in our emergency preparedness kit. Batteries plus bulbs made it really easy to order and have it shipped right to your house. You can also do curbside pickup if you're local here in Sacramento. They are right in Citrus Heights on Greenback Lane and a great resource for building your own family emergency preparedness kit. We have a variety of things in our emergency preparedness kit. We have a small tool kit as well as a small first aid kit. So first aid and tools are there. We also have things like dry food, water bottles, larger drinking bottle water, and as well as pet food. So if you have a pet, you want to think about that. We don't have babies, so we don't need diapers or wipes or anything like that. But I did put a Ziploc bag with a change of clothes for my kiddos, so that's always good. I actually love to have this same thing in my car in case of accident. Lantern is a great resource. Obviously, if you needed to evacuate or had a power outage, a lantern is a great resource. A flashlight makes it simple and handheld to have light if you need. This pocket USB portable charger is great. As much as I rely on my phone, I definitely need a charger that is ready to go. Batteries, I don't know about you, but many times we leave our lantern in here forever, and then when we do go to use it, the batteries are dead. So you want to make sure you have a variety of sizes, from AA, AAA, D size batteries, or any other batteries that you might need. Like if you have anyone that uses medical devices or hearing aids or anything like that in your home, you want to think about those batteries as well. This phone charger is really, really neat. I've never seen one of these, but they are small little compact ones, and they're only $5.99, so super affordable. They are in a biodegradable case, so you're being mindful of our planet. They are pre-charged and ready for instant use. It's a mobile phone charger, and it will charge an Android or iPhone, so that is fantastic. And it powers up really quick, up to a 75% boost. And then these are just like a one-time use, so you use it and then you just throw it out. But it's perfect for when power is not available and you need to charge your phone or devices and there is no power. So those are great to have. This converts your car battery into a charging resource. So it has the cables right there to connect to your car battery. But I love this part. It has a three-prong plug-in right there, as well as USB ports on the side. So it can convert any of the DC volts to AC volts that you need right from your car battery. So that's excellent. We also have a lighter in there in case you need to light something. Not inside our tub, but placed right out here on my table. We keep this in our car. It is a portable power charger that will charge your battery up in your car if you run out of power. And this is great if you run out of power in the middle of the night. That has actually happened to us on a road trip. We were not near a gas station or anything like that, so you might need one of those. It's also helpful if you have kiddos that use like electronic devices and run the power out of your battery or leave like the light on or the door open, things like that. This is super helpful. You can do it all on your own. You don't even need someone to give you a jump. You can just do it with this neat device. You also want to keep in mind to have some paper products, paper towels, paper plates, cups, utensils, some other more dry food. Okay, so I want to hear from you all out there watching. Do you guys have a family emergency preparedness kit? And then is there anything that I should add to mine? Any thoughts, ideas, suggestions? I appreciate your likes, your shares, and commenting down in the comment section. Thanks for watching.